I would like to interview Mr. and Mrs. Furukawa. はい。The same, no. 同じ質問でいいですか? The same question about any physical changes. 健康被害みたいなものがあったらどうぞお願いします。どう?
私は2012年の10月まで郡山にいたんですけれども、
ちょっと待ってね。
So we stayed in Koriyama until October of 2012.
そこまで体が弱い子ではなかったんですけれども、
お子さん何人いらっしゃ
るの？あ、一人です。
一人、男の子な
の？女の子です。
Okay. ああ、そうだ。
So we have one daughter, and we know that our daughter was not weak. However,
震災後、咳が止まらなくなってしまって、うん、それが1ヶ月以上とかやっぱり続いたりしていて、うんうん、それで医者に行っても、うん、それはその放射能というか被爆とは関係ないからっていうふうに言われていて、うんう
んうん、
So what happened to my our daughter was the fact that right after the accident, she started to cough. That continued so long, more than a monthSo we brought her to a doctor, and the doctor said that, oh, it's okay, it's nothing to do with the radiation.
で、そのまま風邪みたいな感じで診断されたことが多かったです。
多かったとか何回も行ったわけ。
何回も行きました、病院には。
同じ病院？
同じ病院です。
So we brought her to the hospital and asked the doctor the same thing over and over and over again and over and over and over again. Doctor would say, "Oh, it has nothing to do with the radiation. It's just the cold. That's the always the same diagnosis."
で、うちの場合は、1年生の時だったんです。で、車で1年間は送り迎えをしていたのがまあ良かったのか、鼻血とかっていう。
So at that time she was a first grader, and we decided to give her a ride. You know, we used to drive her to school, and we used to go pick her up by car. So I think that prevented her to be exposed to radiation compared to those children who used to walk.To the school, so she didn't experience any much of the nose bleeding and things like that. However,
ただその分運動不足になってしまって、mm-hmm. やっぱり避難した先長崎に避難した時には、mm-hmm. その他の子の体育とかについていくのが本当にやっとな感じで、mm-hmm. 子供自身はすごくその、mm-hmm. きつかった体力的に。Mm-hmm.
So our driving was, you know, good in a way that we prevented her to be exposed to radiation outside. The ramifications from this was she didn't have enough exercise. So when we relocated to Nagasaki, during the time of physical exercise classes, she didn't have enough physical strength to go through the program together with her classmates.
避難してからは風邪をひく回数とかもすごく減ったんですけれども、ただ長崎から埼玉の方に避難した時に喉の調子がちょっと悪くて、病院に行ってこう触診、長崎から埼玉の方に移動引っ越ししてきて、それでちょっとある時風邪ひいて病院に行った時に喉が腫れているのか甲状腺が腫れているのか触診ではわからないんで、血液検査をしたら甲状腺に疾患があるっていうふうに言われて、それでちょっともうちょっと早く避難しとけばよかったなっていうふうにすごく後悔しました。
She was okay when we were in Nagasaki. Then we relocated from Nagasaki to Saitama. And as soon as we relocated to Saitama, our daughter said that her throat started to hurt. So we brought her to a doctor, and the doctor started, you know, when the doctor touched around her throat, he said that he wasn't sure whether it was just a regular inflammation or something was wrong with her thyroid. or not. So eventually she went through a blood test, and the result was showing that something was wrong with her thyroid, which made us really regret that we should have relocated much earlier.
震災後にやっぱり外で遊べなかったっていうのもあったし、体育の時間も本当に最初は体育館とかだったんで、走るのも遅いし、自転車にも乗れないし、泳げない、未だに本当に泳げないっていうのもあって、やっぱり未だ日本には体育の授業は苦手な。
So because of the, in order to prevent our children to be exposed to radiation, in Fukushima they prevented kids to play outside. As a result, they used to do the physical exercise classes indoor. That was very limited. So my daughter was very slow with running. She still cannot swim. That's the kind of thing that we regret.
と子供だけじゃなくて、私自身もやっぱりその甲状腺に異常があるって言われて、だからその当時にいた、まあ、大人の子供だけじゃなくて、大人もやっぱりこの検査を受けた方がいいっていうふうには言われました。
So eventually, they foundthat I also have abnormality with my thyroid. So the lesson from this experience is that everybody, not only children, but all of them, if they were in Fukushima during those days, they should have go through all the thorough medical checkup.
Yes.
Hi.
どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you so much. So next, I would like to interview...Ms. Yoshiko Ota from Minami Soma.
Okay. 私は3月13日の夜にもう埼玉に向かったんです。
So the night of March 13th, 2011.I was already on the way to Saitama Prefecture from Fukushima.
警戒区域が20キロまで、警戒的に強制的に出されて、うちは22キロぐらいだったので、もうすぐ逃げなきゃっていうことで、目の前がもう入れない状態なので、向かったんですけど、一応子供が2人、上の子女の子、下男の子、やっぱり下の子の鼻血は出ましたね。
Okay. So we used to live in like 22 kilometers from the Fukushima Daiichi, and we had to relocate immediately. We had to leave our home immediately. Unfortunately, one of our kids, younger one, he experienced nose bleeding a lot.
で上の女の子は特に異常もなく、で埼玉県が特にそこまで何でしょう、普通の学校生活だったので、普通に運動もしましたし、特に問題はなかったです。
So our older one was a girl, didn't have any experience, didn't have any physical difficulties or any change. So, because we relocated to Saitama Prefecture right away, our children went through a normal lifestyle as a young kids. So, okay, that's it.